Nunamakers inside the Nazareth wrestling room. An in-depth look at the training, coaching techniques, and drills used in the making of a nationally ranked team. With Ray Nunamaker, the legendary Nazareth coach who retired in 1997 after 34 successful years of coaching high school wrestling in Pennsylvania. Ray's teams never had a losing season in 34 years. Ray amassed a record of 468, 95, and 7 against top flight competition in District 11, Pennsylvania, and the nation. His teams were nationally ranked from 1990 to 1997. Ray was Pennsylvania Coach of the Year 4 times and was inducted into the Pennsylvania Wrestling Hall of Fame. Ray retired as the second winningest coach in Pennsylvania wrestling history.
Trouble. He's going to pin him. Jamie Rice in his first round.
Oh my! Oh my!
with the ball. Nazareth, 25, Easton, 28.
How well does Ray Nunamaker know his wrestlers? Sending Jamie Rice out there to do this. And now he's sending out one of the top wrestlers in the country, Rob Roan, to finish things up. Rob Roan could pass for heavyweight.
And 43 seconds, 1:43. Barbara locks it up for the Nazareth.
First in a series of videotapes that deal with the 1996-97 Nazareth wrestling team. We're going to take you inside the Nazareth wrestling room to show you the coaching techniques, the training, and the drills that go into making a nationally ranked team. This first video deals with the first week of practice. And in this video, we're going to show you a concentration on what I consider five of the essential skills. And they would be on your feet, the high crouch, and the single leg, along with the double leg, is a finish. On the bottom, the stand up and the sit out. And on top, the cradle position. Sit back, relax, enjoy the season inside the Nazareth Wrestling Room.
We climb ropes every day before practice. To me, it's the most important thing we do for grip and forearm strength. Running is also an important part of our daily routine. We run or jump rope before or after every practice.
Essential to have a written plan every day so you just don't go in there and wing it, but you have it down to the minute. Let's sit back and let's go inside the room and discover what the Blue Angels are doing today in practice. Alright? If you're with someone that you think has it, there's some chem clean, rub it over your body so that you can be protected from getting it. We're pretty well covered. Our biggest problem will probably be getting someone at 103. And JV probably 125 or 130. I know we run, we get out there, start doing some stretches. Some of you need a little more time to stretch. Make sure you get it in. Alright? Good person is gonna suffer. And the stretch, Mike, it's not just like this, you know? Get up. And your ankle. Between your legs, reach behind. And then go back again. Loosen it up. and then turn, face the opposite wall. Let it stretch.
As soon as we're done with stretching, we begin our basic movement drills, starting with spinning.
Like you never left, right? We'll go over this way so she can get this check. Gotta be aware of the camera. All right, when you spin, there's an outline here that you put your chest on. The reason for that, just go on spin as if there's a spike on it. Right there, now spin front. Now you see that, if he were to put up his arms, it'd be too easy to stop you from coming around. So the idea in spinning is to keep more on this line so your feet are further away from that man. Go ahead, try and go around that outline now, Chuck. There you go. I think that's a better way to spin. There's a little less chance to get stopped when you're doing it in that, so you want to do it here in practice. When you hear the whistle, switch, the other guy goes on top. Okay, everyone should have a circle. If you don't have a circle, go in between the circles. Let's get you set up. Alex, right here, Jim. Someone take that circle. Fitz, Jeremy. Come on, Alex. Right here. Right here. Over in the spot. Right there. All right, spread out. It's going to be more time. Right here, Dan or Lawson. It's fun back. You room right here. That's your spot. All right, here we go. Ready? Go. When you hear the whistle, switch.
When we're finished with the spinning, we're going to go to a drill we call bridge flips.
Alright, now you come up, Jared. Peek over. Good. Alright. You're having difficulty. Guy walks backwards, pull on his feet to help you over. At first, you may have a difficult time doing it. Keep practicing, you'll get it. Here we go, everyone up, bridge flip. Up four, down. Up five, down. Start watching your weight now. Now that doesn't mean that you're gonna cut water weight, all right? What it means is you wanna cut calories. You wanna count amount of food. Remember, the body maintains a certain water level, all right? If you deplete water level now, you're not really losing weight. All you're doing is making yourself feel terrible for a long period of time. The only time to cut water weight is 94. All right, then you can lose 3-4 pounds that night. But if you start right away, it's doing you absolutely no good, all right? Start taking low-cal drinks. Start drinking water. Water's as good as anything. But your body's just like a sponge. And if you squeeze it out and get all the water out now, there's nothing left in it. Alright? Keep your water up, cut your weight, but don't cut any water. Alright, come on. This is a good warm-up drill right here. Go ahead, Chuck, Chris. Get into the man, get your feet moving. Alright, good. What I don't want to see is this, Chuck. Show them how beginners do it. Come backwards. Next step, just come in, lift them up. Catch them, then the other guy does. Go ahead. Up. There you go. Hold them up. Name your turn. Go ahead. Step in. There you go. Next. Up.
We've just covered four of the basic movement skills: spinning, bridge flips, pummeling, and hip toss. And now we're going to go into the stance. We go over this stance whether it's an experienced team or an inexperienced team because it's so basic. From this stance, we're going to cover movement, penetration, and circling out when you get snapped down to the mat. From there, we're going to go to a shoelace drill, which teaches a boy how to react against a leg shot. Also, we try and stress the best time to get a person's shoelace is when he's retreating from a shot.
Assume the stance, your feet a little more than shoulders width apart, and your face up. Not your head up, because you can have your head up and your face down. Faces up, elbows in, right here. You're lined up between your shoulders, your knees, and your toes. Straight line right there, right in this position. You can go square, or you can go chicken foot. It doesn't matter. I don't really care. There are advantages to both of them, all right? If you're square, you can shoot either side. You have to be able to counter either side. Sugar foot, obviously I'm going to shoot with this foot, all right? But I know I'm going to defend with this arm, my wizard arm. most people are right-handed, you come with the right arm. All right? So I probably prefer it a little bit here, just to mix things up. It's up to you. I don't really care. Doesn't matter. We've had successful people square, without them sugarfoot, whatever you like. All right? When you move, there's short, choppy steps. All right? Never cross your feet over for too big a step. Why don't you take too big a step, Mason? All right, you can trip. What else? All right, come here, Mason. Right. First caught on video. This will be a great video. We should put bloopers in it, too. All right, now take a real big step, Mason. Real big step. Not towards me, to the side. To the side. There, yeah, real big, even further. There, now, if I do that, you're going most balanced, right? So that helps a little bit, right? Or if you cross your feet, once. Right? Okay, good. Alright, so you want to move here. Right here. Alright, side to side, keeping your face up. Alright? That's the first thing I do, just get a good stance and movement. Alright, everyone up five, good. Now, every time we're drilling a move, stay in that stance. I'm tired already, alright? Every time we drill a move, I want you back up in stance. Remember, Andy, how you did that beginning of the year last year? Yeah. I want you to keep it up all year. Because it definitely makes a difference. I remember saying, Andy, you keep that up. You're going to be in our state finals. This year, you're going to win the thing. All right? Do it all year. And I know now you're fresh. You know, get up and relax a little bit. You're fresh. You're ready to go. But you got to have your mindset what you're going to do. You know, it's purely a commitment. And you got to commit that you're the best there is. And let me tell you something. It's not what you do in December that counts. Is it, Bob? When is it most important? In March. That's when it all counts. That's the preparation, you know? Everything else is a lead up to March. You agree with that, Chris? I mean, that's our philosophy. Granted, we like to win everything. Win the whole ball match, beat everyone, go undefeated. But it's a little bit, you know, unrealistic. There's only one team in the nation probably can do that, all right? So your purpose is to get yourself prepared for that mark. How do you do that? By getting the best team, the best individual you can wrestle, and by using it to improve yourself. All right, here we go. Good stance. Ready? Stance! All right, I'm going to move you with a hand. And when you move, semicircle. So you're always closing the gap. Don't move straight in a straight line, but semicircle. So you should go like this, then over here. Ready? Move.
Hands up.
Hands up. Movement. All right, do that. Coach calls it, what do you call this? Wheels.
Wheels.
Do a little wheel in here. Side to side. Good at it. Sit. All right, good. Face up. Move.
Hands of defense. Give up.
All right, wheel. A little wheel. All right, what I want you to do, when you're going to penetrate, all right, we're going to go here. I'm going to have you lower your hand and drop it right here. But I think it's very important when you penetrate, you lower your level. I'll do it this way. Lower your level. Keep your face up. And you're going to step. As soon as you step, hit your knee. As soon as this knee hits, this leg comes up right here. When it comes up, you drive at that angle right here. Then you have a quarter on your shoulder and pinch it. So it's like this. Lower your level. Penetrate right here. Up, and then over here. Big step. You don't want to go straight in the man, you want to take him at an angle. You go straight in, you're going to get a cement job right over top. Take him at an angle. All right, here we go. Slow it first. Stance. Now, you know what foot you're shooting with. Do this very slow and deliberate. Take your lead foot. Step. All right, now, as soon as that knee hits, bring up your opposite foot. Now, penetrate. Right over there. All right, here we go. You've gotten away with it in midgets, you got away with it in middle school. Coming out here and shooting for a leg. But I think you gotta learn from a tie. So probably the first things I'm gonna do are all the inside tie. Take an inside tie, it's right here. Alex, see this? Thumbs together, right here. Alright? These are fish hooks. And with the fish hooks, I can move this man. If I wanna move his foot this direction, I pull him down right there. If I want to move him over here, I pull him there. If I need a little help, I use his hand, put his head down. right here. Move him back here. Right in here. To this side. Either side. Controlling him right here. Just moving. My time. I hit him right here and down right in here. Alright? Let's do that much.
250.
Alright? You should not be here to here. Here, here, here. Someone will think you're clear. Right. Forehead to forehead. Alright? Here we go. Movement. Right hand left. Right hand left. Snapping down from here, because a lot of guys stand like this. And I think if you're drilling that way in practice, you ought to know what's going to happen to it. I'm going to snap. Alright? I'm going to take this hand, I'm going to bring him down here, but what do I have to do with that foot? I got to move it. I can't come up with it, so I got to move it back. When I snap him, I club him down. It's not really a snap, it's a club down. So I'm in here moving him around. When I snap, I go down here. Just come down, Chuck. Right here. His movement is not to stay there, because if he stays there, I'm going to beat him. He's got to get out of there. And he's got to realize that that's very vulnerable. So as soon as he hits, he immediately lifts his knees off and swirls out to the side. So I look like this. I'm in here, right here, I snap down, he comes right out, gets back into position. Movement, snap, he's right out again. Ready, snap, right out, okay? Snap. Squirrel out. Okay, ready? Snap!
The purpose of this drill is to teach kids not to go down on their hands and knees. It's my belief that if you're down on your hands and knees, you're going to get a beat. So you notice they squirrel out. By that we mean circle around and then come out back into a good stance. The next drill we're going to cover is called a shoelace drill. The purpose of the drill is to improve your reaction against leg attacks.
For instance, let me just show you what we're going to do. Chris, if you go down and untie my shoelace, I'm going to just move it out of the way. Go for the other one. Right here, I'm going to just step back. So you're going to try and avoid it, all right? He's going